It did, and then today it actually weakened pretty quickly. And this is the kind of cycles we may see. So when you hear that there's a Category 5 storm out there, well, it'll go down to a 2, it may go back to a 5. It'll continue to fluctuate. Here's where it is right now. Here's Puerto Rico, here are the Leeward Islands. It is still well out to sea and not really impacting any land areas. But during the day today, the storm became, well, it came into a less favorable environment. So it kind of got sheared apart a little bit. So let me show you the latest from the Hurricane Center. Earlier today, Category 5, now down to Category 3 with winds of 115. It will further even more, weaken further even more by tomorrow down to a Category 2. But after that, the Hurricane Center has it ramping back up, going back up to a 4. By Monday, and then here's where the track becomes a little bit wider. Notice how wide the cone is here by Wednesday as a Category 3 storm. I think Wednesday is going to be the critical day on this, and this is as far out as the Hurricane Center forecast goes, out to Wednesday. They go out 5 days. Well, let me show you other plots here. These are what we call spaghetti plots. So this is a number of models that will go out 7 or 8 days to give you maybe an idea of where this thing is going to be headed. So this is where we are tomorrow, and we've got about 5 or 6 models on here. They all don't go out more than 7 days. But as you can see, as we get into the day on, I'll stop it here on Wednesday. Wednesday, you can see that the storm in all of the models begins to turn to the north. They don't all agree exactly when it makes the turn, but on Wednesday, it all makes the turn. And then, of course, one model is just quite a bit different from the others. That trend will continue, taking it parallel to the coast of the United States. And while not all the models go out this far, as you can see, there is a consensus, at least among these two, to take it toward Nova Scotia. No idea of how strong it may be. It may not even be a hurricane by then, but at least the consensus we're seeing in the models is that it takes it east of the coast of the United States. But again, that can change over the next couple of days. In the valley tomorrow, we'll see sunshine. Midday temperatures will be near 80. Afternoon temperatures low 90s, a lot like what we saw today. The foothills will have a great looking Saturday. By noontime will be around 79 through the afternoon, mid to upper 80s. And then for the High Sierra, beautiful day around Tahoe and Truckee with afternoon temperatures in the low 70s and with a breeze. I'll talk more about what we can expect through the weekend and next week in just a couple of minutes.